Hello friends, today we are going to take very interested topic in these days, that is various investment avenues for the small and medium investors. As far as India is concerned, India is actually the country of small and medium investors, where people, you know, are sacrificing their small saving so that they able to make some kind of investment and they will able to survive in the future. So this slide is very much basic for all the, you know, customers or the investors who does not earn in bulk, and the primary concern is not to have the higher return, but at the same time they want to ensure that their principal amount will also be safe within the organization. They don't want to lose their principal amount. Principal along with the return is what they are expecting as a small and a medium entrepreneur or investors. So taking this slide further, one of the, you know, basic instrument that is available to the people is every person, you know, should open a saving account. Why we were saying that saving accounts are crucial? As far as interest rates are concerned, the interest rate are not that as much in comparison to the other instrument, but yes, at least if you are putting the money in the saving bank account, that you are at least earning something from your saving. For example, nowadays State Bank of India pays approximately 3.5% as an interest rate on the saving deposits. These interest rate are, you know, on a very much on the lesser side, but at the same time we can say at least you are have done something as far as your investments are concerned, and you have started and you became the part of the formal channel as the financial sector is concerned. The saving account can be opened with any bank, maybe nationalized, maybe private sector bank, maybe cooperative bank. This is one of the basic instrument. Nowadays our Prime Minister is saying that if you want to, you know, take the benefits of the government facilities, then all the subsidies will going to be credited in the saving account. So you must have a saving account, and you have to fulfill some KYC feature, know your customer, in which you have to link your Aadhaar and PAN card with your saving account, and you can avail the facilities of the saving account. Next important component, you know, of the investment pass is the recurring deposits. Recurring deposits also take place in the bank, maybe, you know, in a public sector bank or a cooperative bank. Here the word recurring is used. Recurring means it will be going to be continue, you know, the period will be continue, maybe on a monthly basis, maybe quarterly, maybe half yearly basis, but the benefit you are going to get from the recurring deposits is the compounding. Compounding is basically the factor. Suppose if you are having a deposits on a monthly basis, so month after month the principal amount changes and you have got more potential to earn higher interest in comparison to the saving account. So if you have a small saving of 500 rupees or 1000 rupees, you can start an RD with the bank and you can accumulate a reasonable amount of money. At the same time, bank also give the privilege that you can break this FD if you are finding it, sorry, you can break this recurring deposits you are finding it difficult. Next important, you know, component which is there in your small investment avenue is the fixed deposits. However, the fixed deposits are losing their charm because the interest rate on the fixed deposits are reducing day by day. But still, the most of the people in India who don't have very much access to the financial market will go for the fixed deposits. These are also the secured kind of investment. In India, you can have the fixed deposits from 15 days. You can have the deposits from the minimum duration of 15 days. It can go till the end of the 5 years. If you open a fixed deposit for the 5 year, it can also, you know, protect you from the tax liability, and it are actually considered as a tax saving investment. The fixed deposits can be opened with the corporate houses, but in largely in India, the fixed deposits are more popular with the banking channels, and people who are having saving account definitely have some kind of fixed deposits in the same kind of bank. FD provides a good return, but if the inflation rate is on the higher side, then these investments are not that fruitful. But this is the reality that still people have a lot of trust and faith in fixed deposit because they are ensured that principal amount will remain same. Fourth important component which we are going to discuss is the insurance plan. Each and every individual, whether you know belongs to good financial background or from a lower kind of financial background, he should have an insurance plan. These days very crucial for the family protection. This insurance plan can further be divided into following three categories. These are traditional plan, ULIP plans and term plan. Let us try to understand. Insurance are basically been developed as the product where primarily the person is looking to protect himself from the risk. But over a period of time, certain kind of riders have been included in the insurance. So now the insurance are working as a risk protection plus investment. Term plan is actually the plan in which you are not going to get any benefits if you survive. But yes, there is a huge risk cover. For example, if you take a term plan and you are paying 5,000 rupees in a year and nothing happened, nobody dies. So this 5,000 will be regarded as a cost of the plan and you will not going to earn any returns out of this. No, there is no return available on the term plan. But yes, if something happened in between this year, you can get the higher compensation from the party from where you have taken the insurance. ULIP are actually the plans where the premium amount which has been taken from you will be deposited and will be going to the equity markets. ULIPs are primarily, you know, not being sold well by the insurance company. But nowadays, it is again picking up as, you know, the advisor are clearly stating the, you know, potential investor that the money which is going to be collected will be going to the stock markets and it do carry a higher amount of risk in comparison to the traditional plan. Traditional plans are actually the plans where you have some kind of survival benefits also. And if you die in between, you will be having something kind of, you know, lump sum amount to be received. In India, LIC is considered to be the primary player in the insurance market. It still date hold the majority of, you know, insurance products which the people are having at their disposal. Next important, you know, the component of the small saving is the public provident fund. It is very much important that every small investor should go for PPF. Again, the returns are not the on the higher side, but still the protection of, you know, principal amount along with the interest. One of the characteristic feature of the public provident fund is that both the investment as far as the maturity value are actually the tax free. You will get the benefit of the tax exemption. PPF, you know, there is a lock-in period of 15 years. So if you are planning a long investment where you don't want to disturb and you want that, yes, our money should be safe and at the end of a 15 year, I have some lump sum amount, then PPF will be termed as a best option to the investor. And since lot of small savers are being involved in PPF, the rate of interest are also not, you know, change so much frequently as far as the PPFs are concerned. Another important component which is slowly getting the popularity these days, good for the small investor, is the mutual funds. There can be various category of the mutual funds. Some options are very aggressive, some are defensive. Depending upon the scheme, the fund the investor should invest in a mutual fund. It is actually a pool of fund, small saving from different people will go and assemble and will be termed as a pool. And the fund manager is actually the person who is actually going to manage all these pools saving, and they are going to put the money into different scheme available. Some schemes may be more directed towards equity, some scheme more directed towards debt, and some is having the hybrid kind of nature. So our discussion today is the small and medium. So for a small and medium person should go for debt kind of mutual fund or hybrid kind of mutual fund, and they can purchase any mutual funds depending upon the scheme at the NAV value. net asset value. Another option that is available to the investor is the stock market, but it is a kind of a risky instrument. Person who don't have so much knowledge about the stock market, they should go and first understand the basic concepts of equity and debt, plus they should understand the aggressiveness of the company. Our discussion today is a small and medium, you know, investment. So the person who is going to invest in the equity should go for a less aggressive kind of a firm, and at the same time ensure that they are going to put the money for the longer period of time. Larger the money stay in the organization, more will benefits the person, you know, will going to get from the equity markets, because it has been seen that equity markets earn a returns of approximately 15 to 30% over a period of time. I hope you are able to understand the small and medium savings. Thanks. Bye bye.